Hello, today we're going to talk about why you should use small diaphragm condenser microphones as closed mics when you record drums. Hi, I'm Ulf at HoboRec, and today we're going to talk about some drum miking techniques. As you probably know, the absolute most common microphones we use as closed mics on drums are dynamic cardioid microphones, which is kind of natural because they can handle a lot of SPL, handle a lot of sound pressure. They are not too expensive usually. They can usually also take a lot of beating. And they are also good at taking up the sound pretty locally, so you don't get too much of the sounds coming from around, which is good if you want to cancel out bleed and stuff. But there is another aspect of this too. So today we're going to talk about using small diaphragm condensers on closed mics on your drums. We have a local microphone company here called Milab Microphones. I've been kind enough to lend me their microphones so I can kit out the whole full drum kit with their VM44s on closed mics. Their BDM1, which is a kick mic microphone, it's basically the same capsule as the VM44, but the electronics is a bit modified to handle more sound pressure and also have a character that suits a kick drum a bit better. On the overheads, we're going with a DC96. They are a large diaphragm, but the thing with Milab microphones is they have rectangular diaphragms. And as a room mic, we're going to use the VIP50 because we can put that one in Omni. As I said, today we're going to focus on the closed mics, and the big benefit with small diaphragm condensers compared to dynamic microphones and compared to large diaphragm microphones, they have a really natural flat frequency response, and they are also really good to maintain that same frequency response even off axis. It's just that the things coming from the side of the microphone is just lower, but it keeps the same character and the same frequency response, which makes the bleed a lot cleaner. And I'm going to show you some examples of that, because the thing, when you have a lot of microphones on a drum kit, you're going to get a lot of bleed from cymbals and stuff. Even if a small diaphragm condenser maybe gets more bleed than a dynamic microphone, the bleed will sound way, way, way better. And you're going to hear that. And it's not subtle either. And you can, of course, do this with any small diaphragm condenser that can handle the sound pressure of being close to a drum. That's the most important part here. You also want to be careful so you don't hit them. Have a drummer that knows what they are doing, and keep off the microphones. And another cool thing with the rectangular capsules that Milab uses is that they have the same benefits with the off-axis, that they maintain the same frequency response off-axis, which is not usually the case with large diaphragm condensers. They can be a bit skewed in the frequency response when you get outside of the sweet spot. So let's have a listen. To make this example really, really clear, I'm just going to show you an example first here where I only use the closed mics. We have kick, snare, and two toms. It's four microphones. We're just going to listen to those. Here we go. Now I'm going to play the same drum beat again, but this time I've replaced all the microphones with probably the most common dynamic microphones. I'm not going to mention them because this video is not about bashing other microphone brands, because those microphones are really great for what they are, and everything depends on situation. But if you want a really natural and transparent drum sound, you're going to hear what I'm talking about. We're going to just listen to a short clip of that again, and I'm going to just A-B switch between them so you can hear it really clear. And I'm going to admit that issue will not be as big when you put on the overhead microphones and the room microphones. You're going to drown that a bit in the overall cymbal wash, but it will still be apparent, and it will also affect the sound of the cymbals. So if you want to have a really clean cymbal sound and use dynamic microphones, you probably will have to gate it really hard. And that might not always be a good idea if you want to have a really natural and open drum sound. We're going to listen again with the overhead microphones and the room mics too. First, we have the small diaphragm Milab VM44s. And now we're going to listen to the version with the dynamic microphones. We'll be right back. And again, a little A-B test. And there you go. Thanks again to Milab for lending me the microphones. Go check them out. I'm going to leave a link in the description. So if you have the chance to try out some small diaphragm condensers for close miking drums, I really, really recommend doing so. And thank you so much for watching. And please subscribe if you haven't already. And if you want to know more about my work, you can find some stuff in the description. And that's pretty much it. So thank you so much for watching and see you again next week. Bye-bye. Cheers.